Welcome back, students. We were seeing the topic on control and coordination. So in this session, we will see about the nastic movements. Now, nastic movements are the movements which are directed to the response which are not determined by the direction of stimulus. That means the direction of nastic movements is not determined by the direction from which the stimulus is applied. That means from whichever direction the stimulus is applied, it affects all the part or the organs of the plant equally wherever the stimulus is applied, and it is mostly exhibited by the flat organs of the plants like leaves, petals of flowers. Okay, and the most common example can be the sensitive plants. Now let's see the first type of nastic movements is thignomasty. It means the non-directional movement of part of plant in response to the touch of an object. The example for this can be the mimosa pudica. You know, in other words, we can say that thignomasty is a nastic movement of a plant part in response to the touch. You know, sensitive plant Mimosa pudica, which is also known as the touch me not plant, what happens when you touch the leaves of this plant with the fingers, the leaves fold up and droop immediately. Okay, so this folding up of leaves of a sensitive plant on touching is an example of nastic movement, right? So here stimulus is the touch of your finger. Okay, now this occurs due to the sudden loss from the pad like swellings called pulvini present at the base of the leaves of the plant, and which make the pulvini lose their firmness and causes the leaves to droop and fall down. Now after a gap of 15 to 30 minutes, what happens, the leaves which are folded, these leaves return to the original position. Why? Because the water usually diffuses back into the same cells of pulvini. Okay, next comes the photonasty. Now this non-directional movement of part of plant is in response to the light. That means what happened, the example can be of this is the dandelion flower. Now the dandelion flower, you know, opens in the morning and it looks like this, okay, in the bright light. But if we'll see in this image at the night, it looks like this. So what happens? The opening and closing of petal down flowers in response to the intensity of light is an example of nastic movement. You know, the opening and the closing of flowers in response to the light. This is in the daytime or this is at the night. Now the opening and closing of flowers in response to the light are the growth movements. You know, petals open, their inner surface grow more than the outer surface. On the other hand, petals close when their outer surface grow more than their inner surface. Okay, now let's have a look over the plant hormones. As we all know that plant hormones or the phytohormones regulate many functions in plants. Now let's have a look one by one on this. They help in the germination of seeds. They help in the growth of roots, stems and leaves. Again, in the movement of stomata. They are very helpful in flowering of plants. They also have major role in ripening of fruits. Again, hormones are also involved in the tropic anastic movements of plants. Okay. So students, in this session we have seen about the anastic movements of plants. Further, we will see about the coordination in animals. Thank you.